Aye. Okay, so now we're going to move right into the last panel. And this is really where we need to hear back from you, the audience. If people please could take their seats and maybe carry on the conversations afterwards, because we really do need to move forward with the program here. What we will do in this panel is really discuss the vision forward. So how do we get to where we need to be from where we are right now? So we've had 2.5 days of very intensive discussions, high level, local level, boots on the ground, community, federal government, everything sort of has come together. And now we want to talk about how we move this forward. And what we will do, we again have three excellent panelists on the stage with us, and we will introduce them and ask each of them to start with some opening comments. After that, Dr. Bartlett will do his 10 top topics that he pulled out of this meeting, and that will be our meeting summary, our overall meeting summary, and then open it up to you for comments, suggestions, in terms of what this community can do to move forward. So with that, I will ask John to introduce our first panelist.
Well, it's a great honor to introduce our first speaker, and for a reason that is not obvious, but he and I are now meeting, and we're on the same faculty at the University of Maryland. And I've admired him from a distance for a very long time. So I'll get to the point. This is Dr. Cuddleill. He's the co-director of the Institute of Human Virology's Clinical Research Unit at the University of Maryland, and I think that's with Bob Gallo as the other co-director. He has worked previously at the NIH, at NIAID, and has done extensive research on hepatitis B, hepatitis C, HIV pathogenesis and treatment. With his expertise, he has served on as the scientific director of the NIH District of Columbia program on AIDS treatment. During his tenure at NIAID, he has developed new therapeutic strategies for treating and managing chronic viral infection. In my context, with his career, is that it's incredible in terms of what he's been able to do with hepatitis C treatment. So he will be our first speaker.